Hello my dear students, in this video we are going to study lesson 3, the Delhi Sultanate. Already we have completed this lesson. Once again I am going to revise this lesson. In this lesson we discussed about the invasions. Many foreigners, they came to India, they plundered and destroyed palaces, temples, cities, etc., etc. Okay, and next we discussed about the establishment of Delhi Sultanate, different kinds of dynasties, slave, Khalji, Tughlaq dynasties. So in the introduction part, we discussed about the Turkish conquest of North India. In the 11th century, many rulers of North India, they were very weak. Taking advantages of this, many invaders, they came to India, they captured India's many parts and they made their own empire in India. So first we discussed about Mahmud. He was the ruler of Ghazni. He invaded India 17 times. He raided India 17 times and he plundered, took away the wealth of palaces, temples, cities, and he destroyed many places also. Then we discussed about Muhammad Ghori. Muhammad Ghori, he came to India and he also plundered the wealth of India, and by 1190 Muhammad Ghori territories include Punjab and Sindh. And at this time, Prithviraj Chauhan III of Ajmer and Delhi was the most powerful Rajput ruler of North India. Muhammad Ghori, he also wanted to control Punjab, and this led the war between Muhammad Ghori and Prithviraj Chauhan. In the first battle, 1491, Prithviraj defeated Muhammad Ghori, but in the second battle, 1192, Muhammad Ghori defeated Prithviraj Chauhan. Later he died also. Okay, and Muhammad Ghori occupied Delhi, Ajmer, and he captured many areas of India. But at the time when he lived, or after this, Muhammad Ghori returned to God, leaving his Indian territories in the charge of his trusted slave and able general Qutbuddin Aibak. Qutbuddin Aibak, he, after the death of Muhammad Ghori, Qutbuddin Aibak, he proclaimed himself as a Sultan of Turkish territories in India, and he started on the first dynasty, that is slave or Mamluk dynasty. Actually, Qutbuddin Aibak, he was Muhammad Ghori's slave or servant. Mamluk means slave or son of a slave. So he started this dynasty, and what was the name of the dynasty? Slave or Mamluk dynasty. He, Qutbuddin Aibak, he was a generous ruler and a great builder. Qutbuddin Aibak's son-in-law Iltutmish became the next ruler after the death of Qutbuddin Aibak. After Iltutmish, his daughter Ruzia ruled until she was murdered in 1240. Then we discussed about Ghiyasuddin Babur. He was a member of Khalsa. Okay, and next we discussed about Khalji dynasty. The Khalji dynasty was established by Jalaluddin Firoz in 1290. And in 1296, Jalaluddin nephew Alauddin murdered him and proclaimed himself as Sultan. And Alauddin Khilji was the ablest ruler of Khalji dynasty. He conquered, he captured many areas in India. And after him, we discussed about another dynasty, that is Tughlaq dynasty. It was started by Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq in 1320. Ghiyasuddin was a just and efficient ruler. He suppressed revolt and repelled a Mongol invasion. And in 1325, Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq was succeeded by his son Jonah Khan. And Muhammad bin Tughlaq had received education, literature, religion, philosophy, etc. Then he made many, or he adopted many policies. But actually these policies or these plans were not worked properly. But they were never carried out properly. This was a failure. These plans were a failure. What was the plans? First, he shifted his capital and he introduced token currency. This was the main plans. First, he shifted his capital. Through this, he lost lot of money. And after the death of him, his son, Firoz Tughlaq, became the next ruler. okay, and he also made some reformations. He was a builder. Firoz built many towns and cities such as Jaunpur and Firozpur. And next we discussed about Timur invasion. Timur Lang was the ruler of Samarkand in Central Asia. He invaded India 1398 and occupied some territories in the northwest. Then we discussed about Lodi dynasty. Actually, these Lodis were Afghan tribesmen who entered India during Muhammad bin Tughlaq's reign. Bahula Lodi was the succeeded by his able son Sikandar Lodi. Sikandar brought the nobles under his control. Last we discussed about Ibrahim Lodi. Sikandar Lodi, he was succeeded by his son Ibrahim Lodi. And at this time, Rana Sanga, the ruler of Mewar, and extended his territories up to Baina near Agra. Ibrahim Lodi replaced senior commanders with young loyal leaders. So this displeased many of the nobles. The governor of Punjab, that is Daulat Khan, he invited Babur to India for defeating Ibrahim Lodi, and Babur invaded India and defeated Ibrahim Lodi in 1526, the battlefield of Panipat. So last we discussed about causes for the decline of Delhi Sultanate. The Delhi Sultanate, which lasted for more than 300 years, or for the first reason is weak rulers. Okay, that was the main reason. Then different kinds of invasion. Timur invasion gave a lasting blow to the already weakened empire. At the same time, the inability of the Sultanate to maintain control over the southern provinces resulted in the establishment of the Vijayanagar and the Bahmani kingdom. Okay. These are the important things we discussed in this lesson. Muhammad, a Turkish ruler of Ghazni, carried out 17 raids between 1000 and 1027 to plunder India's wealth. Around this time, the Persian scholar Al-Biruni wrote his account of India more than 150 years after Muhammad's raid. Muhammad Ghori invaded India to conquer it. Okay, but and in 1192, Muhammad Ghori defeated Prithviraj Chauhan at Tarain and took Delhi and Ajmer. He defeated the ruler of Kanauj and his generals further expanded the Turkish territories in North India. After Muhammad Ghori's death in 1206, his general Qutbuddin Aibak, the Sultan of the as the Sultan of the Turkish territories in India, he established the slave dynasty, and Aibak's son-in-law Iltutmish stabilized the empire and finished building the Qutub Minar, begun by Aibak. And next we discussed about Balban, the last great ruler of the slave dynasty, took stern steps to control nobles and strengthen the empire. Next we discussed about Alauddin Khilji, brought Gujarat, Malwa, several kingdoms, Rajasthan and Deccan under his control. Muhammad bin Tughlaq, we discussed about Muhammad bin Tughlaq. He shifted his capital Daulatabad and then back to Delhi. His plan of conquering Central Asia, this Tibetan campaign, this taxation scheme in the Ganga Yamuna Doba, and his system of bronze coins all failed. It was a failure. Many provinces broke away because of this unwise policies. Then we discussed about Firoz Tughlaq could not win back the lost territories, but he reduced taxes, improved agriculture and commerce, built new towns, canals, mosques, etc. and promoted learning also. Then we discussed about another invader, that is Timur Lang, invaded India and looted Delhi in 1398. Timur governor Khizr Khan established Sayyid dynasty. And then we discussed about the Sikandar Lodi, the most successful Lodhi ruler, founded the city of Agra. Ibrahim Lodi, the last Lodhi ruler, was overthrown after being defeated by Babur at Panipat. And with the defeat of Ibrahim Lodi, the Lodhi dynasty and Delhi Sultanate came to an end. Babur established the Mughal Empire in India. Okay, these are the important things we discussed in the last videos. I told you that already we have covered this lesson. Anyway, I have summarized again for you. Okay, so if you have any doubt, again you can ask through the comments.